So, in sport and physical activity, there's a thing which the body can do called redistribution, or blood redistribution, also known as vascular shunt mechanism. But what it basically allows our body to do is redistribute the cardiac output around our body according to demands and according to where our body needs this blood the most. So we can increase the delivery of blood to areas which are working, and we can decrease the delivery of blood to areas which aren't really working. And inside of that blood, obviously, we have oxygen and nutrients being carried to the site. And then the more blood that arrives, or the less blood that arrives at a site, that starts to impair the CO2 and the lactate removal as well. But obviously, if we have a part of the body that isn't really working, therefore there isn't much CO2 or lactate being produced, then we don't actually need much blood being supplied to that area to take those limited supplies away. So blood distribution or redistribution is something that occurs during exercise. Now, for this question here, you can get up to one or two marks just for stating the different mechanisms involved with this process. And we have vasoconstriction and vasodilation. So just knowing those two different terms can get you points in the exam. Now, if you can back that up with the definition, even better. But we're going to start off with vasodilation. Now, dilation, similarly with our pupils, dilation means to get bigger or to expand in the lumen size, or the circumference and the area within the space. So dilation of the vessels, they expand in size, and in doing so, more blood can fit in them, therefore more blood can flow through them, therefore where these vessels are connected to, they're going to be fed a larger quantity of blood, because the vessels feeding them with the blood have gotten bigger. There's a greater flow through them towards that area. Now, what determines which tissue gets the most, or this increased blood flow, that's determined by the activity and the exercise that we're doing. What sort of demands are being placed on our body? Is the environment demanding from our quads or our hamstrings or our gastrocnemiuses or our arms or our core? Is it a cardiovascular event which is quite intensive for the respiratory muscles, such as our abdominals or diaphragm or intercostals? Have we just eaten a meal? Therefore, our digestive system is going to require a larger amount of oxygen and nutrients to allow that system to actually complete all of its processes properly. So vasodilation is when the arterioles, so we've got the artery, the big, thick vessels that carry blood away from the heart, we then split these down into smaller arterioles, and it's these which can dilate, they can expand, and they can allow a bigger blood flow to go through them towards the areas of higher demand. The opposite is vasoconstriction. These arterioles could, in fact, contract or constrict, so they actually become smaller than they are at rest, therefore inhibiting or limiting the amount of blood that can actually fit inside them, therefore flow through them. So by combining these two mechanisms, if we dilate the ones feeding the tissue that needs the blood, needs the oxygen, needs the CO2 and lactate removal mechanism, and we can constrict the tissues en route to the tissues that we're not actually really using, then we get a positive net effect. The tissues that need the most blood get more, and because we've actually restricted blood going to the areas of the body that don't need it, there's a greater quantity of blood that can then be diverted into these dilated vessels going to where we do need it. So, two ways the body can redistribute blood during exercise: vasodilation and vasoconstriction. Vasodilation means to expand the arterioles which feed the working tissue, and vasoconstriction means to reduce the size, to constrict the space inside the arterioles which are flowing towards the tissues which aren't being needed or aren't being used. And that's that. So I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you again in the next exam question. Bye for now. We'll be right back.